Anker F3000 is probably the best introductory power station that Anker has released so far. It's an affordable, thoughtfully designed power station that can grow with you in the future. So can Anker wow us again with another new release? Or if you're in the market for a unit this size, are you better off going with something like the Delta Pro? So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. As always with a brand like Anker, we have high expectations. They've been known to have a really good attention to detail, and they clearly put a lot of time and money into R&D. Their units aren't always a home run, but you hope with every new unit that they release that we're just that much closer to perfection. And after our time with it here at the lab, we've been running it through some pretty good testing. We have some things that we really like about this unit, as well as some potential red flags, depending on how you want to use it. But if at any point during this video you guys have heard enough, we will leave links to this unit in the description down below, as well as any coupon codes we can get from Anker, and information on this month's giveaway. So before we jump into our experience using the F3000, let us hit you with a super quick spec tear down in case you're not already up to speed with Anker's newest power station. First up, this thing passes the tiny baby lift test. It weighs about 92 pounds. It has a 3,072 watt hour battery bank, and it's actually expandable up to 24 kilowatt hours with two units and two expansion batteries each.
I think 3.
In terms of inverter on this guy, it's actually got a 2400 watt output from the regular 120 volt house plugs, as a 3600 watt output from the 30 amp. This unit only does 120 volts, obviously based on the plugs, but you can do 240 volts of output with two units and the 240 volt hub. In terms of getting power into this guy, you can charge it with a regular house outlet in your home at 1800 watts, which will charge it in just over 2 hours. Or this unit actually has a 30 amp plug you can get, so you can charge it at 3600 watts, which will actually charge this thing up in under 1 hour flat, which is pretty cool. And if you're trying to charge it with solar, it has a 2400 watt solar input. It's split between two ports though. So you have a 1600 watt like high voltage solar input and a 800 watt low voltage solar input. In terms of ports on this guy, you have your four regular 120 volt house plugs. You have a true 30 amp plug, which is nice. You have a 12 volt car socket and an Anderson port, which is a very interesting move on Anker's part. Don't really know who's gonna use that. You have two USB-Cs and two USB-As. And on the far side, you have your AC grid input, as well as your expansion battery ports. And in terms of the rest of the build, it's actually really nice. It has nice spacious handles you can grab right here. Big knuckle health and safety is gonna be able to get his meaty little hands in there, no problem. You got the classic suitcase handle and wheels. This one actually feels really sturdy. It moves around really nice. I prefer this layout than the F3800. I think this is a much cleaner setup. The screen is great. It's a classic Anker screen, shows you what you need to know, nothing more. You have your nice big light across the top. And overall, it's pretty solid. There's no real weak spots on this guy. Like, it feels like a really well-built unit. It works with Anker's app. Anker's app is one of the better apps you can get. It lets you control the unit from afar, set time of use settings, do a couple things that you can't do directly from the unit. And the price, at the time of this video, seeing that the F3000 just launched, you can get this thing with our discount code for $1,631. We've been told that once the early bird special is over, it's gonna be about 1800 bucks, which is honestly still not a bad price. The first thing that we liked about the F3000 was honestly just the way it performed in our testing. They advertised this thing with a bunch of fancy numbers and specs on their website before it launched, and we were really hoping it would live up to everything that they claimed. In our testing, it was 84% efficient, which is honestly really good. Anything over 80%, we usually give it a thumbs up. Idle consumption was way better than we've seen Anker have in the past. Something like the F3800 was about 80 watts of idle consumption, meaning if you just had this thing on, just with the AC inverter on, just running, it would use 80 watts every hour just sitting there doing nothing, which is way too much. This unit advertised, I think Anker advertised 24.
24.5.
They advertised 24.5 watts of idle consumption. In our testing, we actually saw it run 20.5 watts of idle consumption, which is really good. It basically means if you had like a sump pump plugged into this, something that comes on and off intermittently, while this unit is just sitting there idling, doing nothing, but the AC inverters are on, it could run just over 6 days. So that's a huge step up from the F3800. And everything else on this guy worked really well. The UPS works, but you can't use it above the charge rate. So with a bigger unit like this, you can only use UPS up to the 1800 watts or 3600 if you have it plugged into a 30 amp. Solar input works well. It's extremely quiet. you can have this thing ripping and it makes almost no noise, which is nice. Anker has finally made a unit that's dead silent. A couple other things that we really like about this unit is the 30 amp. Anker gave us a true 30 amp on this, which we really, really enjoy. A lot of companies will give you a 30 amp plug. Even the F3800 has a 30 amp plug, but it only outputs 25 amps. So it's only 3000 watts out of this. This gives you 3600 watts. So if you plug it into a trailer, RV, that kind of thing, you're actually gonna be able to use it to the maximum ability, which we like to see. We also really like the layout on this guy. It's actually nicer than the F3800. This is more like the F2600. It's more like a Delta Pro. It's got this classic power station build. And honestly, it's way better than being tall.
Being short is better than being tall. That's what you're saying.
In your case.
Tiny baby.
The handle and the wheels, like we already said, everything feels solid. And we actually really just like the overall build on this guy. And we also just really like the attention to detail that we tend to get with Anker units. It has little rubber feet on the back handle here, so you can actually stand this thing upright if you're trying to get it packed away or tuck it in a corner to get it out of the way, or you just like that tall design of the F3800. You can still stand this guy upright and still use it. It does have a 12 volt car socket, which is really nice for doing camping stuff. I'm sure that someone has a use for these Anderson ports. We don't typically see like name brands give us them, so it's a little interesting, but both great for camping and doing that kind of stuff. And of course, we have the big unibrow light on top. If you guys have a power station with a light, you know how important it is to have a light. If you don't, you're missing out. You need a light. And the last thing that we really like is that this has a quick charging mode that you can use the 30 amp plug, like we said, to charge at 3600 watts, meaning we've been talking a lot lately about charging a power station with a gas generator. So if you're in a power outage, you could actually run a gas generator for under an hour, charge this thing from zero to full, and then turn off your gas generator, back to quietness, and just use this until it's empty again, which is nice. We really like that we're starting to see those higher inputs for power stations. And you can also pass that power straight through. So say you had this hooked up and at the time you were running 3600 watts out of this, you can run that generator past the 3600 watts right through. Whereas most of the time, units only let you put in like 1800 watts or whatever. So if you're trying to run a big load and you're putting in a small amount, you're gonna end up killing the power station anyway. So just a small thing that Anker did well on this. Good job. There is though, some things that we just don't like about the F3000, starting with these regular wall outlets on the front. In our opinion, they should have taken advantage of more of this space that they had and spread these out. We found in our testing that there's a lot of times where you're trying to plug multiple things in and they overlap. If you put a camera battery in this, it basically completely destroys your ability to use the other plugs. Like anything big and bulky, it just overlaps the plugs beside it. It's cool, yeah, that these ones are facing down and these ones are facing up. So if you had grounded plugs, they don't overlap, but I just think that you could have spread these out a little bit more and given us a little bit more room to plug in bigger plugs. And speaking of plugs, Anker has switched to this proprietary charging plug. This is the plug that you use to plug it into your wall and get regular 120 volts into the unit. Typically, all power stations use the same plug almost since the dawn of time. Even when EcoFlow started switching over to like the newer bulkier plug, everybody started switching over to it. The only reason I don't like this with the little twisty lock and whatever is because when this breaks, you're gonna have to pay a premium on Anker's website to get it. You can get the other cords on Amazon for like 10 bucks. And also with that plug, it's so big that when you actually stand this unit up with the little rubber feet that we were talking about, the plug doesn't fit underneath. So you can't charge it with it erect. and if you're someone that likes it erect, that could be a problem for you. The two solar inputs is also annoying. Again, I know why they're doing this, but I just wish we could get either one solar input or multiple of the same solar input. Anker on the back has given us an XT60, which is like a regular foldable panel input, and then their own proprietary input. So again, you have to have the Anker adapter to be able to plug panels into this to take advantage of the maximum solar input. Just seems like there's too many moving parts. Give us like one input that has a wide range, or give us a couple of the same inputs so we can string everything together the same. We don't need to jimmy things up in a weird way.
Plus the Anker panels are expensive. That's why we recommend you getting it from Shop Solar. And that's also where we're gonna link you guys to because it's actually a better deal.
And the last thing that we personally don't like about this unit is that it doesn't work with the F3800 expansion batteries. It's like EcoFlow does a really good job at this. Every EcoFlow, except the Delta Pro Ultra, you can use with every EcoFlow expansion battery. You can have a Delta Pro 3 running off a Delta 2 Max expansion battery. Like they all interconnect. There's adapters, there's all sorts of stuff. This one, if you're already part of Anker's ecosystem, you cannot use Anker's expansion batteries. You have to get the specific battery to this unit, which is just kind of a buzzkill if you're expanding or adding onto your system or whatever, and you already have products, you can't link them all together. I wish you could. It would make me feel a lot better about spending money on something if it worked with other things from the same brand. So look, at the end of the day, the F3000 is a great unit from Anker. As long as the price, in our opinion, stays under $2,000, it's a good buy. You guys know that power station companies and all these solar companies, really, they love to mark things up and then have them on like a permanent sale instead of just giving them an accurate price. The retail price on this is $25.99,
something like that,
which is almost the same as the F3800, and it's the same as the Delta Pro 3. If this is under $2,000, it's a good deal in our opinion. It makes a lot of sense. It's capable and powerful for the price. If it creeps up in price, there's a lot of more competitive units that I think, like the Delta Pro 3 runs 240 right out of it. But for this price that it's at right now, or even 1800 bucks, I would 100% recommend this to a friend. It just, there's good attention to detail. It works well, feels like a quality unit. And we were honestly pretty happy with it. Anyways, we will leave links to any coupons that we can get for you guys from Anker in the description down below, as well as information on this month's giveaway. So make sure you do not miss that. We will catch you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.